But why, some say, the moon? Why choose this as our goal? And they may well ask, why climb the highest mountain? We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
In the eighth year of manned flight into space, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration prepared men and equipment for the most advanced manned mission to date.
Apollo 8 was the first flight to the moon. We had information that the Russians were going to put a man around the moon in the late fall of 1968. Consequently, we changed Apollo 8's mission to fly to the moon, orbit the moon, and come back, and we did that over the Christmas holidays. We had to build a Apollo spacecraft that would hold three people. We sat on top of a large rocket called the Saturn V. It was a three-stage vehicle that gave us enough velocity and on the proper course to coast all the way to the moon.
The engines are armed. 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. We have liftoff.
Man, perhaps on the way to the moon, if all continues to go well.
My two companions were Frank Borman and Bill Anders. That was the three of us that made the flight.
Houston, I hear you, Apollo 8.
Yeah, we hear you loud and clear, Apollo 8.
Okay, first stage was very smooth, and this one is smoother.
Understand, smooth and smoother. Looks good here.
The flight took about 3 days to get to the moon. We had charts of the various craters that we wanted to see. We wanted to look at the flat areas for making landings and later flights.
Houston, what does the old moon look like from 60 miles, over?
Okay, Houston, the moon is essentially gray, no color.
We didn't know the significance of the mission with regards to things that we did or things that we said until we got back home. It was the fourth orbit when we finally came to a position where we saw the Earth.
Oh my God, look at that picture over there. There's the Earth coming up. Wow, is that pretty. You got a color film, Jim?
And then Anders asked me for colored film.
Hand me a roll of color quick.
Oh man, that's color. Where is it?
Quick.
Hey, I've got it right here. Let me get up there. Bill, I got a phrase that's very clear right here.
And he and Anders does take, I guess, several pictures. And I say 250 at F11.
Well, I got it right. Oh, that's a beautiful shot.
And as Anders takes the pictures, one of them, as we learn after we get back home, became the very famous one.
Following a direct descent flight path, Apollo 8 traveled 1,560 miles across the Earth's surface and splashed down in the Pacific with pinpoint accuracy.
When we landed, of course, we were well received, being the first flight around the moon and very successful in getting back. But the country in 1968 was sort of in a turmoil. Martin Luther King and Bobby Kennedy both were assassinated. We had a war going on. It was one after the other of bad news, either in Vietnam or in the continental United States. And then the launch of Apollo 8 brought a binding to the people of our country. It was a very significant factor in how people felt about themselves and their environment. The Earthrise photo, in just one picture, gives the person a complete understanding and glimpse of his or her position in the universe by looking back at the body that she calls home. It was the first time that people actually knew what the Earth looked like and where they were living.